Hi, my viewers. This is Paul again, coming to you here in Indiana to talk to you and to share some commentary or some stories or some topics that may be of interest to us. So, as our people. So, first and foremost, I welcome you to this channel. If you haven't subscribed, you can subscribe. If you haven't shared this video to a friend, you can share the video, like it, and comment on it. So, guys, welcome again. If you're new, subscribe. And if you are a returning subscriber, appreciate it. So, guys, as I had said earlier on the other video, that I'm trying to do some different of kind of a content, because due to the kind of work right now I'm doing, it's no longer the self-employed job I was having where I could do whatever I want. Right now, I'm working under a company, a trucking company, so it's kind of more restrictive, more regulated. You know, when you work for a boss, you know, it is his term, so it's kind of tricky. But all in all, you know, you use the time available to do something, because, you know, YouTube has come to, you know, to change the conversation, so I want to be a part of it. So first and foremost, I've been thinking of just picking a topic and just talking about it. And then you guys can share, comment, discuss about it, and then we can respond in the next videos and do a different topic. So guys, your guidance will be highly appreciated. So today I was thinking of talking about you know, transition from the countries we come from to the United States. You know, it's kind of, you know, the story is that this is a land of milk and honey, and is where dreams are realized. And in America, each dream is valid. And it has been in this kind of notion that the world knows that the America is a land of milk and honey, or fortunes. So everybody who comes here, either legal or illegal, either the way you come here, either asylum or whatever, you come here with hope to change yourself, your life, and the lives of those you love. So technically, every one of us who has come to this country from where we came from is not for any other reason, is to make a difference to our own lives and to those who are around us, especially to those who are back home where we all come from. So that has to be put out there. Secondly, when you come to this country, you come with the belief that things are just glitter, or everything is gold. You know, everything is a walk in the park. You know, you'll come here, find everything lined up for you. You know, all you need to do is set up yourself and everything will flow. That kind of misconception is what has put a lot of us in trouble, especially the young folks, and also, you know, every kind of people who come to this country, who resign their jobs back home, who sell everything they have as they take this journey of faith. So I just wanted to come to you to this platform, and just we discuss what are the misfalls, like what are these things that people out there think that, you know, they will come and find here. Unfortunately, or to their surprise, they come and find out, ah, man, it's not what I thought it was as initially, you know, when I was coming around. So these are the kind of things I want us to deliberate upon, to, you know, have a conversation on. And perhaps one or two people out there who have, you know, who have great opportunities where they are, but they keep complaining, or they keep thinking that there is better place up here. I'm not saying it's not a good place, make no mistake. If it were not for this place, my life would not be the way it is. So, and it has really propelled me from where I was back home in Kenya and who I am right now. I thank God, I thank this country, I thank the people of this country for welcoming me here. So that one, I have to put it out there that this country is, it's good. When you come here, work hard and do what you're supposed to do, for sure you're gonna reap the fruits of your labor. So that has to be said. But there is the overhyped concepts, or the idea of, you know, it's overhyped. You know, when you come here, you have this mindset that it's all a walk in the park. You know what I mean? Like, you don't need to do nothing for you to succeed, that everything is set up for you to succeed. And that is what I want to come here and contest, and also, you know, say that it's not as it is said. And if that is what you think, then you're wrong. First, when you come to this country, you have to understand this country is made of laws and orders. This country is structured in a way that you have to follow what the guidelines of every state. There are 54 states. Each state has its, you know, its state laws, and then there is the federal law. So first and foremost, when you land at whichever airport, at whichever state, you have to understand this, that this country is not where you come from, where you can negate and circumvent the rule of law. In this country, there are consequences. In this country, whatever you do, you are watched and monitored. And if you slip or mistake anything, there are consequences, and you pay them dearly in the short term and in the long term. So, you know, you have to understand. That's the first thing. The second thing, in this country, there is nothing for free. You cannot come in this country and presume that just because you slept and woke up here, you're gonna make a living out of it. You have to grind. You have to wake up every morning. You have to go out there and do what you're supposed to do. Like in Kenya and other countries, you have to hustle, guys. You have to wake up in the morning. You have to, you know, you have to have short time sleeps. You cannot be sleeping 8 hours, 10 hours, 14 hours, or 24 hours and expect to make something out of it. So guys, that has to be put out there, that hard work pays in this country. It's not a free ride. You have to work hard, you have to grind, you have to sweat and tear. And guys, it's not as what people say it is. People work hard. You go out there, you find constructions, guys. People do landscaping at a heating sunlight, man. Heat is so high, and you find guys doing landscaping. When you see these moving, when the lawns are made, when everywhere looks green and the trees are all set up like it's artificially made, man, these are men and women who do this kind of work, and they do them in under harsh environments, man. Either it's snowing, either it's freezing, either there are crazy winds, either it's raining, man. It's the sun, man. You find sometimes it's 100 degrees Fahrenheit and people are out there. Sometimes the government said, oh, there is a heat wave, and man, there are guys who are doing these jobs. You find in the construction, in the highways, you go everywhere, people are building dams, people are in the military, everybody is grinding. We are in the transport business, we do this job night and day, man. This is a crazy world. Everybody is out there hustling. So if you think that if you're not hustling back where you are, you think you're gonna come here and just have a free ride, that's not what it is. So guys, wherever you are, you're gonna have to grind, wake up in the morning, do the best you can, because everybody is doing that, even in this country where we are, guys. The beauty of this country, the difference between this country and Kenya and many of other African countries, and by extension perhaps in the Asian continent and etc. and the Arabic continent, is that job here pays. When you work, you see the fruits of your labor. So that is the encouraging thing, that every man and woman who goes out there and grinds and works hard, he comes home with good bread. So it's not like back home. Those who work less get paid more, and those who work more, they pay less, or even they are not paid. They are misused, they are abused and used. So in this country, guys, that's the beauty of this country. You get paid for your work. You get paid handsomely. You feel good when you come home because you're paid. You are encouraged to wake up the following morning to go back to work, because the motivation is in the currency. So every moment that dollar comes through your paycheck, you look at it and say, wow, I need to step up, because this job I'm doing is making sense to me. So that's the beauty of it. The beauty of this place is you get paid what you work for. So it's not like in our country where you sometimes work, toil, do everything as you're supposed to, and then when you look at your payments, man, it's tax, there is nothing, man. You can make any moves. So this country has set it up that those who work hard, they get something out of it. The other thing I wanna just comment as I go on with this topic is that, as I was saying earlier, in this country you have to be careful, because you can either succeed or fail. If you do some things that will put you in trouble, your records are put, they are tarnished men. You go there, drive carelessly, you go there, have violations in your license, man, you cannot even get employment. Because here there is something they call CORI, there is something they call background check. So what happens is, if you want a job, the first thing, in the first time, they get your fingerprints. Then from there, they take your records through your social security and everything. And then the FBI runs, or the federal government, through the FBI, they run your background check. They check if you have any records that are not of good conduct. So the moment they come with, you know, drug use, weapon, all kind of issues, man, no employer wanna be attached with you, man. So when you come to this country, my brothers and sisters, be careful, you know, stay in the line of law. Don't engage in activities that will put you in a state whereby you are here in this country but you cannot work. Or even if you can work, you cannot even work the formal setup of jobs. All you can do is under the table jobs. So guys, you know, keep yourself, put your head up, and also stay under the radar. Don't be this guy who is all over the place doing all kind of things, and eventually you find yourself in so much trouble in terms of your records. And here you are in this country, people back home are looking up on you, and yet still you can't even make bread for yourself. So guys, that has to be said. It's so many things that can put you in trouble, and we'll be talking about them in the next video. But for now, I just wanted to say, in a general view, just follow the law. Follow the law. Don't do things that will put you in trouble. The other thing, guys, we need to discuss here is the future of